My name is Ruchi Jain. I'm currently a student at Harvard Business School. And I actually had the honor, I think, of working with Reach Ivy and with Vibha while I was applying to graduate school. And I think Reach Ivy played a huge part in my successful application. This speaker series is a great way to get a head start on your application process, whether to Columbia University for your undergraduate degree or any of the grad schools at Columbia. We have Columbia Business School represented here today.
I'll start with introducing our guest speakers for today. We have Avanti Maluste and Neha Kamani with us. You know, when we meet students at Reach IV, we constantly stressing the importance of extracurriculars. But from an Indian mindset, there's this focus, obsession with grades and scores. So in your families, when you were growing up, how stringent was the focus on grades?
Grades were a focus in that it was expected that I do well, but it wasn't ever a primary focus. I think I was, you know, my dad in particular really encouraged me to explore other interests, get involved in sports, particularly team sports, still does. Hasn't happened yet. I've always been a swimmer.
Well, I think for us too, grades were important in that there was just an underlying expectation that you have to do well. But I mean, that kind of luckily just came sort of naturally. But I think there was a lot of focus, not just on extracurriculars, but also on out-of-the-box thinking. So my dad, if I ever came home with 100% in economics, that was like incidental for him. You know, he wanted to know whether I understood what was going on in the world, whether I could really kind of open and expand my horizons and talk about different events from around the world. And that was always given more importance than coming back with, you know, 100%.
You both went to school in India. You were in high school in India, and then you transitioned at the age of 16 or 17. And move to a foreign country. Can you share your experiences for some people who are about to leave, at the cusp of leaving, and how was the transition, and you know, what did you have to adjust to when you went to America?
So in the Indian education system, as I'm sure most of you know, it's very focused on rote learning. The fundamental assumption is that if theories are established, you don't challenge them. And in the United States, more often than not, the idea is if there's a theory that's been established, it's actually just kind of a hypothesis and you're free to challenge it as much as you like. So that was kind of the dichotomy I faced. In some ways, I think the Indian education system prepared me really well.
So for me, I think I loved the transition to the US. You know, I was looking to get out and I was looking to be part of a more global environment, a more global campus. And I just loved the diversity, you know, both in terms of, you know, people where they were from and what their backgrounds were, especially in business school. You know, when you really meet, you're more equipped, I feel, to handle the global diversity than you are when you're in undergrad. I think undergrad, you're still young, you're still learning. Business school, you're learning too, but you're a little more aware of everything around you. And I think you know, just the diversity factor was amazing. It takes a little bit of time to get used to. You'll make a lot of faux pas, and trust me, I did. But after you get over those, then it's a fantastic experience.
So a lot of schools talk about diversity. You know, every business school presentation I go to or meet the undergrad admissions officers, they talk about diversity on their campuses. Can you give us a glimpse into your classes to give us a tangible sense of what diversity really means?
My friends in particular were really diverse, but you know, the one thing that really stands out now, 4 years after I've graduated, is really the intellectual diversity. And what's really interesting to me now is that none of us is doing what we thought we'd be doing at the start of our college careers.
They try to design the business school so that every cluster that you're part of, so in the first year they divide, I think, 350 of us or whatever into 8 clusters. And within clusters, each cluster is supposed to represent the diversity of the school, and within that they'll divide you further into study teams, and each team is supposed to represent the diversity of the school.
So there's a lot of curiosity about what is it like to spend a day on one of these campuses. Can you just share your experiences? Like, I know there's no classic typical day, but just give us a glimpse into a day at university.
The one thing I remember is that it was always packed.
I think with business school, everybody's experience can be very different. Like, you can essentially divide business school into 3 parts. So the first part is the first semester, the second part is the second semester, and the third part is the second year. So your first semester is insane. I think it's the ultimate challenge in time management. So it's a big reality check, and I think it really trains you well for even post-business school life.
When I finished business school, I had taken an abundance of classes. There's a plethora of courses available, the diversity, operations, marketing, finance. At the undergraduate level, it's even more options because you have the law schools and all this diversity mixed in. If you had to recommend one class that someone took at your university, which one would it be and why?
So rule of thumb, if there's a class and you know the professor is fantastic, take it. It doesn't matter what the class is, because if you've got a good teacher, he's going to make you like it, like the subject. So I signed up for this class called Ignorance my senior year. I had absolutely no idea what it was about, but it was taught by the head of the neuroscience department. He's really dynamic and really entertaining and really makes you want to be him.
I think I would totally echo that. Pick the professor, not the class.
So when we meet students, we tell them college is a transformational experience. Can you please elaborate on how Columbia transformed you as an individual?
I explored a bunch of interests that I would not have otherwise. And that forms the crux of the beauty of the American undergraduate education system.
Business school really humbles you as a person. I think after undergrad is a very individual experience. I think it's a very sort of, you know, you learn about yourself, you go through everything yourself. Business school is a very communal experience. So you can't just live in your own cocoon and go through business school and come out and think that you live through business school. I think you're constantly interacting with a lot of people who are a lot better than you are. And better is actually the wrong word. They're just a lot different. You know, everybody's got their own strengths and everybody's got their own story. And, you know, you just realize how amazing it is to be part of that overall story. Because also in business school, if you decide to kind of dissociate and live your own life, you're not going to make anything out of business school.
What job opportunities came your way post-Columbia, and how did the school facilitate your job search if it did so?
I'd never done these sorts of interviews before, and so the career office was really helpful in training me for them.
If you're interested in something, they'll definitely put you in touch with the right people. So they'll be very upfront. They'll say, well, we don't really have a channel where we can bring these people to campus, but if you would like to meet with them, we can definitely make that introduction.
Can you just share with us one or two concrete ways in which you've applied learnings from Columbia, from your undergraduate experience and from your business school experience, in your professional life? How did your college learnings translate into the professional realm?
You work with clients from every single industry possible. And over the 3 years I worked at Kearney, I was working in cement, in retail, in IT strategy, in water management. So that really kind of makes you learn things really. It makes you a really fast learner, and you have to really pick up sort of the key points of everything very quickly so that you can go to a client with a straight face and say, hey, I know what I'm talking about. And I think Columbia helped me in that way.
And in business school, if you want anything, you have to be resourceful. If there's something you want to learn, you have to email someone and you have to set up time. And I think out of undergrad, those things don't naturally come to you, whereas you know, in business school, you have to do that. And
Columbia, of course, is very, very competitive. At the undergraduate level, last published acceptance rate was 6% acceptance. What do you think stood out in your application? Can you just highlight two or three key things that you think made your application stand out?
What really stood out to me and what I realized about my essays was that they were really honest and really genuine. And I think that's what's important. Like, you need to be true to yourself.
I think for business school too, I would echo that. I think if you're not genuine, I think it comes through very easily to somebody reading your application. So, I really loved the application process. So we have a lot of young people in the audience here, and I would really encourage that, you know, just follow your dream and follow your passion. You know, I mean, it's just the best asset that you have, and everybody has a unique story. So try to focus on bringing that out as much as possible. Maybe your unique story is not what this particular school needs.
Application process is extremely tedious and demanding. How important do you think the craft of writing is in preparing a successful application package?
I think it's really important. I think you have a very limited amount of space to tell the admissions office what it is about you that will make you a good fit at whatever school, and you need to portray that clearly. So writing is important.
We in India, we're good at English. We, you know, we come from good schools. We can get access to that structural format of an application. How to do that? Well, I think that's very important. But I think more important is to really tell your story in a very genuine manner.
Another important aspect of the application process is the interview. And you've both interviewed candidates and you've been on the other side of the table with someone interviewing you. So in all these years of interviewing experience, can you share some key highlights of what you think makes a successful interview?
You know, from my experience interviewing undergraduates, I think the three really important things that come through. The first is don't tell me what you think I want to hear. The second is do your homework on Columbia. The third thing is, so I want to see impact.
So you don't have to stick to a format, you don't have to stick to a script. You can guide the interviewer. I think the best interviewers are when you start, as a person who is being interviewed, you start leading the interview. That's when you know you're doing a good interview.
Could you share some advice for the parents in the room, please?
Be realistic. You know, don't put too much pressure on your child, because it's stressful for you, but it's stressful. It's really stressful for them too. And it's the first time that, if you're a high performing student, it's the first time you're kind of being put on the chopping block, so to speak. The second thing is during the undergraduate years, I think really allow them to explore their interests, because those are the only 4 years that anyone really gets to do that to a large degree, and you never get those 4 years back.
I would say don't stress. You know, I mean, a child is a child at the end of the day, and you have to just let them grow in their own way. I mean, when we grew up, we didn't have all this, at least I didn't have all this sort of, you know, lasered attention focused on me. And I think that's good. It's a syndrome of how, you know, the second child always does better than the first one because less attention is focused on them. So I really believe in that theory. And I think, you know, your kid may not go to like Harvard or Wharton, but it doesn't, or Columbia, sorry, we're the Columbia event, but it doesn't matter. I mean, at the end of the day, 10 years later, everybody's going to be together and doing something or the other that suits them. And I think just believe in your child and just hold their hand through whatever path they want to take.